What a deck!
Hello and welcome to the What a Deck, where we play troll decks, rogue decks, and whatever the hell Joe feels like. I am not Joe, I am Captain Cardsworth.
And I am Hardleg Joe, the usual host.
Good timing there, Joe.
I'm sorry, I thought you were going to introduce me. My apologies. But today we're playing Captain Cardsworth's Machina Gadgets. This is your actual deck, correct?
Pretty much card for card, how it's built in real life.
Yep, and it's I don't know, have you really fought against pendulums or anything with it?
I beat Ignites once.
Okay, well that sounds... I know you won that one tournament against Burning Abyss and they were super salty.
Yeah, no, it was against Kleehorps, that's
oh,
right.
Oh, okay. So, anyway, this is a decent deck, kind of weird. I'm taking a week off just to work on something after the Super Heavy Samurai fiasco.
Can we get an annotation to that fiasco, Joe?
No.
Hey, I'm in the captain's seat today.
Fine. There's
you will do everything I asked for today.
No, not even close.
Well, you didn't tell me that. Now I've burned my bridge.
Anyway, I'm trying to work on something a little bit more competitive. So, in the meantime, Captain Cardsworth brought his deck. So, if you don't know how this works, if you just want the deck profile, there's a link in the description. Otherwise, we're going to be playing 10 duels against random opponents and seeing how this monstrosity holds up. Any other words before we begin?
Pepper.
Fantastic.
See you first duel. Okay, and here we are in the first duel against Damn You Windows 8 against JJJ.
Triple J, J3, J-Dog. We've got our Machina Gadget sleeves, very handy. I spent a lot of time working on them.
Which you can get for $1 if you donate to the Patreon.
Yeah, or more. You could donate more.
Yeah, you could.
If you donate $50, you get a free video game every month.
And if you donate $500, you're our number one fan. You don't get shit for it.
Yeah.
Except our praise, yeah. Which will be heaped upon you.
But if you want praise, I mean, there you go. I got the hiccups. I apologize. This is like the least professional What a Deck. But this is Captain Cardsworth's episode, so, you know.
So
as long as he doesn't have hiccups. So we're playing against a 50-card, no extra deck situation.
Perhaps Monarchs.
Probably Monarchs.
Perhaps Exodia. Perhaps waiting.
It might be Exodia if it's like the worst Exodia deck ever.
Could be. We'll be back when he finally does something.
Yes.
Okay, we're back. He played a Monarch card. Big surprise.
Sorry, I was trying to hold my breath to get rid of these hiccups. They're making my eyes water and I can't see this action.
Blizzard Dragon.
This is a weird Monarch deck.
Yeah, what? Huh?
Well, and with his Monarch thing, you're not going to be able to destroy that because it was Tribute Summoned.
That wasn't Tribute Summoned.
It was tributed with no tribute.
That doesn't... You're dumb.
I am dumb. What's your point?
I'm just going to go ahead and special our Cyber Madu.
Yep. So what's the theme of this deck?
To win.
Oh, okay. And the tactic?
To win.
Oh, okay. And how do you accomplish this winning?
By winning.
Oh, okay. I see.
See, this is why I don't do Yu-Gi-Oh! Tutorials on my channel.
Ah, you should. People will come to see you. Your name is Captain. It seems like you have more stuff.
I am. Well, you know, you should trust me. I am a captain.
Yeah, what can you summon from the extra deck with a level 4 and a level 5?
Chimeratech Fortress Dragon.
Oh, yeah.
But that would be unwise
it would
at this
be.
Point. So we're just going to go ahead and attack.
At this juncture? You're not going to use your, Smashing Ground and just...
I'm going to hold on to that for the moment.
Oh, okay. Just in case he summons some big fuck-off beat stick?
Perhaps.
I mean, I'm pretty sure you could have OTK'd him right there.
I'm pretty sure I couldn't have.
If you had summoned Machina Fortress and then used Smashing Ground and just done 24, 21, 1800, that equals 8,000.
No, it doesn't.
Almost.
Stop trying to do math while it's my turn.
I'm sorry, the hiccups.
Do math during the opponent's turn when nobody's watching. Okay, we won anyway. See there, Joe?
Best What a Deck ever. Good job.
Great start. Next duel. All right, welcome to the second duel. We're here against Doxy, perhaps Doxycycline. Maybe he's in the pharmaceutical industry.
Possibly. I mean, Fire Fist.
But he didn't.
I always wanted to make a Fire Fist deck, but I don't like them. It's a weird love-hate relationship I have with the Fire Fists. They're kind of neat, but I think all they can really do is, summon.
And play a lot of their spells.
Yeah, they just Tenki Bear Pop, which is the name of my new band.
Except he went for Gorilla.
Oh, okay.
Oh, there's Bear.
Yeah, because he already had Bear. He didn't need Gorilla. Let's see, and that lets him destroy a spell trap. So what you want to do is
kill that.
Oh no, it kills one monster. So yeah, I think just do the same. I mean, you got your cyber dragon, you got your other guy. You might as well just, you know,
do the exact same play as before.
Yeah, I mean, why not?
Yeah.
Do you literally have the exact? No, not the exact same hand.
Very
but you
similar.
Have three, four out of the six cards are the exact same. And he's probably like, fucking machinas. Those are old school, and we were like, fucking Fire Fist?
Those are dumb.
Those are kind of
old
school.
Hey, Machina Gadgets, you know what? They're not meta. The closest they ever came to meta was,
A while ago.
When people used Machina Fortress and Phantom Beasts.
I thought they were like a meta deck when you first made them back in like 2002.
They were quasi-meta because they semi-limited the gadgets for one format and one format alone. What does that do? Why did that kill it?
All Beast Warriors gain 300.
Oh, okay.
That's fine.
18 straight to your doxycycline nipples.
Yep. And then just set all the things.
All the things?
I assume so.
Okay.
I mean, don't set Swift Scarecrow.
I mean, I can't. I normal summon this turn, Joe.
I mean, you could if we were playing in real life. And just hope no one...
And just hope no one noticed?
Yeah.
See, look, he set a Swift Scarecrow.
Yep.
Perhaps.
He's in bed, and then he normal summons again. You probably want to do that because he's going to destroy one monster you control and then attack you for mouse amounts of damage.
Sure, why not?
Also, he has more attack than you. And I'm not sure, you guys probably can't read that upside down, but it says negated, I am a captain. So says me, or so says the captain.
Something I am like the captain.
Yes.
Well.
I would advise Oh, wait, you had things that you could use when he attacked. Okay.
Yeah, see, that's... I'm the captain here!
You are.
What do I do, Joe?
I'd say Machina Fortress him.
With Swift Scarecrow?
Yeah.
Okay.
You got enough stuff to negate attacks.
Good point.
Unless he can, like, clear your field somehow, I don't think you have to worry about it.
Good point,
Joe. Just give him the 2,500 tickle, as I call it. Bada bingo.
Tickle this pickle?
Only for a nickel.
Yar, that's Dancing Pete. He dances for nickels.
Oh, 1,800 even.
Oh, that won't do anything,
He's
Joe.
He's playing the Raven. Nevermore.
What? With your daughter? Oh, we were going for different quotes.
Are you
going
to set the...
Why should I set Call of the Haunted? I have nothing in the grave yet.
You have Cyber Dragon.
What? How's that? What? You were just... I can't set things in my battle phase, Joe.
Nope. That's common Yu-Gi-Oh. It's Yu-Gi-Oh lore.
No, it's not. It's Yu-Gi-Oh!
Is back in the day, Yugi, he tried to set something during the battle phase, and Kaiba was like, no, and that's the story of how
so
he
So he's
set
doing things, Joe, while you're talking and babbling.
He is. You probably should have saved your Fiendish Chain.
You told me to use the Fiendish Chain!
You didn't have to listen to me.
You're in the passenger seat. I have to listen to you. I'm the captain.
Oh, no. When I'm dueling stuff, you say all sorts of words, and I just completely...
Ooh, he brought out a thing.
Yep. It's Horse Prince. He can special summon level 3 fire, but then he's not allowed to summon other monsters that are higher than level 5. But he can Ixie summon because he's got the 3.
Mm-hmm. Now he has the 3.
Yeah, but he can't... for some reason... Or I guess he only has the other level 3.
Oh, it's John's wife.
Target one face-up card to control. Destroy that target. Okay. So he can blow up Machina Fortress, probably.
Ooh,
something like that.
That thing.
Yep. Oh, no. But he has to discard a card for it.
Hey, I can bring it back with this.
You could. See, it's a good thing you said it. It's a good thing. And you'll probably want to banish the Ixie monster, because it has effects it can use.
That was my plan.
Good.
Which one's my banish? That's the banish.
Yep. Ha-ha! It's funny because you are back. It's funny because my phone still has the sound on.
Should I magic cylinder that?
I'd recommend it. I mean, why not?
I agree, Joe.
I concur. Do you concur?
Sure.
And then you could bring back your Machina Fortress, ram it into that.
I know how my deck works, Joe.
Okay. I'm sorry. I just wasn't.
Or you hey, look, I could just try
and attack
for
game. That sounds good.
Do any of these things do things when they're destroyed?
No, I don't think so.
Yeah, okay, so you go summon destroy. Nope, okay. Nope. No.
Unless he has something in his graveyard that summons when you destroy things.
Why not? Let's just go for game.
Yeah.
Eat
good
that.
Thing you happen to draw that one Raigeki you have. Oh, he should have summoned Swift Scarecrow just for the massive disrespect.
Massive disrespect, attack for zero for game.
I could kill you now, but I'm going to give you a turn just because...
Alright, well, we'll go ahead and put that in as a win. Thank you, Doxy, and we'll see you next duel.
Don't thank the people you're defeating.
Alright, here we are in the third duel against Logum.
We got that Logum.
Are you trying to do Ned from South Park?
No. I'm trying to do, like, the Sling Blade mashed potatoes.
I've never seen Sling Blade.
Me either.
Oh, look, it's Monarchs. I've just seen... And this one's actual Monarchs this time.
Yeah.
And not Blizzard Dragon Monarchs.
Yeah, if you guys are watching this, like, later on, or if the meta has changed by the time this comes out, which seems unlikely, Monarchs are the new big thing right now. It looks like he's playing the Lockdown variant. He's going to keep you from using your extra deck, which is,
unfortunate.
Not going to help... Oh yeah, because you don't have, like, Machina Fortress or anything that you really need. He's going to give you the 2800. What is he going to get? Some sort of stupid bitch like Mega Caius, the shadow fucker?
Is that his name, Joe?
That's what I call him. No, he's just going to get another one. He's going to get another Aether, the Heavenly Monarch. Yep, that's Monarchs for you, just shuffling cards, drawing cards, discarding cards to add other cards, to send other cards to your graveyard so you can banish them and have your opponent pick three and then add one to your hand.
How is that again, Joe?
So you can banish and then summon to add the spell cards back to your hand, and that's how you play Monarchs.
And that's how you do the Hokey Pokey.
Yep.
Let's see.
I think you want Pot of Duality.
Really?
Yes.
Can I?
Yeah, why wouldn't you be able to? Are you what? Ooh, Smashing Grounds.
And
ooh,
Fissure.
Oh, but also that Machina Gear Frame, which will help you actually...
It would, but are either of these useful? Like, especially...
Oh, yeah, what was it? The big thing that, that Aether, the one he has...
Yeah.
He can use it from... He can summon it from his hand during his turn.
Mm-hmm.
And I think the fact that he didn't do three Storm Forth means he has the other one set. So he's going to try to tribute your monster, so I think you're better off going with Fissure or Smashing Ground. Ignore the sounds from the Peanut Gallery.
Wait, can I Galaxy Cyclone his thing?
You could, but he can chain it if it is indeed Storm Forth.
But if it's Storm Forth, that won't help him during my turn.
No, because that monster he added to his hand... can summon itself during your turn.
Oh.
By tributing.
During your opponent's main phase, you can banish a monarch from your trap and immediately tribute summon. What?
Yeah.
Well, isn't that just a bitch?
Well, I'd go ahead and Galaxy Cyclone it anyway, just to make sure.
Okay. You're the captain.
Well, I mean, what else can you use it on? You want to get rid of that field spell or that search card eventually.
Oh, no, it was that thing. What does that thing do?
Tribute one level higher, target one card on the field,
negate
its effects.
Why didn't he chain that to negate the field spell effects?
Because he's not dumb. I think that's why.
Yeah.
You want a tribute? Yes, he's so dumb. He doesn't know how Fissure works. He thinks that this targets so that he can do... Like, I specifically made the thing about targeting to explain this. Like, no, now it goes off and kills your other one. Oh, wait, what has happened when it, when it's sent to the graveyard? Oh, okay, no, he's just summoning that because he's...
Damn it!
Stop dropping that on my...
Susan
on,
B. Anthony.
On my video. If you're gonna drop something, drop a sack of Jawea.
Because
everyone should keep their Jaweas in a sack.
Ooh, the only monarch that can use its effect when it's special summoned.
Go ahead, target up to two cards on the field. I'll pick that one and that one. Go ahead, use your
effect.
He gets
to draw a card for each. And that trap he can just summon from the graveyard like every turn.
Mm-hmm. Oh, he's going to destroy his own thing?
It's a pity you can't attack for like massive damage right now.
No, but I can attack for 14!
Ha-ha! And add a red gadget.
Indeed. I like that it searches for you. I don't have to go through and pick out the red gadget.
That is good.
Eat 14 and die!
And then you can,
set a Dark Bribe?
Yeah. Which isn't really good in this deck as much.
No, it's not. Dark Bribe was good when I built this, 6 years ago.
Yeah, because just the fact... It's one of those few cards that can negate, like, anything. Or any spell trap. Back then it was only, like, either spells or traps. There wasn't that much, like... Negate any old...
Confirm three cards. Sure, he has three cards.
Yep.
What does that do?
It lets him search out a Monarch spell trap.
Well, I don't want him to have any of those.
But wait, he has to reveal a Monarch in his hand. Do we know he has one in his hand? He might not.
Sure, why not?
Like, if he does, then we're helping him deck thin. But if he doesn't, then we've doomed.
Apparently he does. Yeah. He has Exubus, the...
Arubius.
Ooh, should I Dark Bribe that?
Yeah. I think that'd be cool, and just hope he doesn't draw it. Why not? I mean, if he has no way to tribute it, if that's what he was trying to go
for. Oh, he drew another one. What a surprise.
I thought you could only activate one Tenacity of the Monarchs per turn. He activated it, even if it was negated.
That's the difference between use and activate.
Oh.
If it said he can only use one per turn, then he can use it again.
I gotcha.
Or he can't use it again, but since activate, the activation was negated, he can use the next one.
Yep, and then the field spell lets him reduce the level of a monster in his hand by up to two, so he can tribute it with one.
Oh, look, there goes my thing. I'm so glad I've got all these little things in my hand.
He's going to send one of them back to your deck.
Send this one back. I already have another one.
Doesn't matter which one he sends. They're all
Yeah, I know, they're all useless, but they're not functionally identical. This guy searches out a yellow, which we have two of. These guys search out a green, which we have none of.
Oh, simple math. See, that's where you get me. I can't.
Are we here, or are we coming back to this later?
I don't know.
Okay. Oh, good. He sent one of the yellows back. Yay. See, that was a duplicate. Now maybe we'll draw Raigeki.
That would be cool. I love that. That's the strategy with this deck. Hope you get Raigeki.
Because remember, kids at home, if you don't play Raigeki, you're dumb. Set yellow gadget during your battle phase? No.
How would that help?
So I don't take damage. Oh, look, he's bringing his trap thing back.
Yep. But he already tribute summoned once. But then he drew a bunch of cards.
He did draw a bunch of cards.
Yep.
Oh, good, I'm glad we put all these dark bribes in here.
Me too.
I'm glad this six-year-old deck runs all these.
You can blow up his field spell now.
How?
With,
Galaxy Cyclone.
Yeah. Forgot you had a Galaxy Cyclone.
I did.
Didn't you? Ha-ha!
Maybe he has his own Dark Bribe? Draw me card? Oh,
nope. He's going to summon another one.
He is.
He wants to make sure he has two at all times. He's just like, I don't know what you're doing, but I got a bunch of defense.
Which one? Should I just set one of these then, I guess?
I'm just going to mark this down as a loss, and we'll be back if something happens. You're welcome.
And so I said to CB, if you take that one down and you pass it around, then you've got 42 Yu-Gi-Oh cards left on the wall. Hey, welcome back to the next duel.
That was really dumb. We lost the last one, by the way. I'm not sure if you got that.
But we're facing a PBS children's show this time, so...
I'm not familiar with what Kaliu is.
I don't know what it is either, but there's DVDs of it at my store, so...
Nondescript DVD store. I'm assuming?
Yeah, sure. We'll go with that. You got a 40 card,
speaking of which, 50
card extra deck.
Some nondescript legumes?
You could say what kind of nuts they are.
No, I have to be as nondescript.
Oh, this guy's playing nondescript Burning Abyss deck.
Nondescript Yu-Gi-Oh deck is what you should have said. What you meant to say, but you did not say.
Sorry, but it's what you overdubbed for me.
No.
Why are people still playing this? I thought Burning Abyss sucked now
no,
with the new
now,
list.
No, now that Pepe is gone... And they got Fiend Rhino. Have you seen that guy?
Yes, I have seen the card. I have no clue what it does.
It's like special summon a fiend monster from your deck. I forget exactly what it does, but it's kind of... what was it? It's send a fiend monster from your deck to the graveyard, so it activates all the Burning Abyss. And it also says other fiend monsters you control can't be destroyed by card effects. So like when he plays it, it doesn't destroy his other Burning Abyss because they can't be destroyed while he's on the field.
Hey, we got our Cyber the Wagon again.
Yeah. Yay. He's got all defense mode though.
Yeah.
And your Torrential Tribute ain't gonna do that much against one of them Burning Abyss.
Because they'll just reset the field.
Yep.
But
you could throw out a whole bunch of stuff and then wait for him to attack and then let him attack into your fucking limiter removal.
I could.
Of course, that would kill most of your things.
It would kill all my things, Joe.
Unless you equipped Machina Gear Frame to someone.
That's true.
Then wouldn't they keep the attack, too?
No, it's until the end of this turn.
Oh. No, it's...
It says right here, until the end of this turn.
Oh, okay.
See, right where you're highlighting, Joe.
I don't highlight things.
Yes, you do.
No, not ever. I've never highlighted things. Annotate to a video where I've highlighted things.
But you do the annotations.
Exactly. And there's no annotations there, so I must never have highlighted anything.
You're a bitch when you're not in this seat.
Yep.
All right, well, we already have two fortresses, so we're going to go ahead and get our other guy.
The Mega Frame?
Yeah.
Oh.
So I can ditch two of these guys to get one of them out, and then I'll have Mega Form to get the other guy back out.
Yay. I think?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what you're doing either.
I don't know either. We're just,
Oh, wait, didn't you want to set limiter removal and let him attack into you? Think like he's doing stuff?
Well, that's true. Should I kill this, though?
This card, you can target one Burning Abyss and special summon it? I'd say no.
No, he's going to let him leave it?
Because the only thing he has in there is Scram, and that's just going to give him more searches.
Mm.
We'll give him as few searches as possible. Wait, can't you equip him to Cyber Dragon?
Yeah, I can.
Haha! Now you'll be slightly harder to destroy, maybe! You'll be harder to destroy, maybe! I don't know, old Jewish voice! Hey! My apologies to all our Jewish fans.
Kale? There can be black Jews!
There can be, but I'm pretty sure Kale isn't one of them. I'm pretty sure on the Patreon hangout he was eating bacon one time.
He's a loose Jew.
See, that's... You know, I could make a joke about loose Jew women, but I won't. I won't because I'm better than that. We'll be back. Oh, no.
What did he do?
Oh, he...
Is that bad?
Yeah. Yeah, it's bad.
They said make it. Oh, gains 500 attack. Okay, well, whatever.
No, the thing is, he banished... He sent a whole bunch of Burning Abyss to the graveyard.
Mm-hmm.
One of them I saw is the guy that lets him target a monster and banish it until the end phase,
mm.
which is not going to matter for your Machina Gear Frame, which means it was a bad thing to equip it.
It was your idea, so this is all on you.
It was, but I didn't know he was going to be playing that. Most people don't play that one, or they play, like, one copy.
Well, maybe he did just get the one copy. See, Joe, You're ruining things. Oh, look, its effect is negated.
Yeah.
But look, it's Burning Abyss Chewbacca. Does that not look like Chewie is a Burning Abyss monster?
No, not at all.
Zoom in. Enhance. See, just what I mean.
That doesn't help it look like Chewbacca at all.
Well, not when you put a pumpkin over it like you did, Joe.
For the last time, I'm never putting a pumpkin on anything. I don't know what I put on there. I haven't decided yet, but it wasn't a pumpkin.
Ugh.
Yep, it's a sad state of affairs. Most people don't play that one either. That's the one that, like, all he does is banish three Burning Abyss from his graveyard to do piercing damage. Oh god, my phone hasn't been on. Okay, that's okay. Never mind. Technical difficulties. With my phone, which what? Doesn't...
Oh, that's bull.
Yeah, it goes to defend...
I didn't know it did that. I've never seen anybody attack with Dante.
I've never seen a Burning Abyss before.
No, I've seen Burning Abyss before. I've just never seen people attack with Dante before.
My name is Captain Cardsworth. It's my impression of you. For some reason, you have an old
man voice.
It's not really an old man.
You're too far away from the mic, Joe.
It's fine.
I can get this out of there, and then we can go into the extra deck.
Well, what would you take?
Oh, wait, no, I can't, because I have a level 5 or higher monster.
Yep.
Well, never mind, then.
It's a sad state of affairs.
I mean, I can attack over these things.
You can, and it would do damage.
Yes.
And I'm not sure if he has the recourse to get away from you. Well, you pitch 2.
To get 1. I could ditch him to get another one. Oh! Who plays Horn of Heaven?
You should play Horn of Heaven.
You mean Black Horn of Heaven?
No.
I've never seen anybody play regular Horn of Heaven.
Because it can negate pendulums.
Yeah, I know what it can do.
Yeah, but Black Horn of Heaven doesn't anymore.
It can negate the exact pendulum summon of 1, if you're only penduluming 1.
It's okay. The point is, you could get another one out, right?
Yeah. Observe.
Behold! Chachinga, as they say in my hometown.
Watch him have another one. Oh, okay, good. Hey, I could take this into this and make a 2,000 attack Ameritech Fortress Dragon.
No.
No?
Okay. Don't do that. Don't.
I'm not going to.
As your official sponsor, I say no.
You're not my official sponsor.
I could be.
Drew is my official sponsor.
Is he?
Yeah.
I didn't even know Drew used to be an alcoholic. Oh, Fire Lake. That's kind of like, that's kind of like Icarus Attack.
Oh, he told my torrential tribute.
Oh, no.
Hmm. Oh.
You actually get to use Mega Frame.
I will use it.
During the battle step.
Since it wasn't yet the damage step.
Yep, except he gets to bring back stuff too, because...
I know what he gets to bring back.
It's Burning Abyss.
But if he brings back his Dante, Megaform can get over it.
Yay, by 100. By a whole hundo. And he can't use the same effect twice, so if one of those dies, you can kill the other one. I think Dante lets him add one back to his hand. I don't know what the other two do. I'm not too good on Burning Abyss.
Oh, I'm Joe. I like Burning Abyss. I know all their effects. Later on, I'm not that good with Burning Abyss. I don't know all their effects. Than you.
I know what Dante does. He's like the Burning Abyss. I know he can't use two Burning Abyss's effects, the same one. Okay, so I guess he didn't have that one before.
He's doing things, Joe. He brought this thing out.
Oh, I don't like that one.
Isn't that the one that we don't like?
Yeah, that's the one that's going to let him attack directly.
Oh, well, that's nice.
Yep. Good game.
No, he might not have a 1300. We'll pencil this in as a loss. We'll be back if it changes.
I got a pen.
What is he doing, Joe?
Well, you see, that guy, when he's sent to the graveyard, he can banish a card on your field until the end phase.
Mm, so it's good game.
Yes.
Well, then, why not? Ha! Eat that! You can't banish a monster with over 5,000 attack. It's too strong for you. We'll be back next duel.
It's too big for the banish zone. Just like my penis. Oh, it's Ruki Okuchki from Bleach!
Welcome back to the What a Deck, by the way. We've got our...
I don't know how the Bleach theme song goes! Someone in the drive-thru can hum that for me. And by drive-thru, I mean comments. Oh, hey, it's the Satellite.
Did you really just drive-thru?
Yeah. I have a phone. So I usually don't work the drive-thru. I usually work the grill at a nondescript hamburger joint.
Steak and Shake?
Yeah. Where these chairs are from. And,
should I smash and ground that and go for max damage?
No, because then he's just going to summon it back.
Good point.
I would just go for maximum hand advantage.
So get another yellow.
Yeah.
No, I'm going to get another green. Green is stronger.
Whatever you want, man. So anyway, I was actually working drive-thru, and I had, like, the most hilarious... So this old man pulls up. Ooh, counter. He negated and destroyed.
Well, that's unfortunate.
Now it's in the graveyard, and he can summon it and stuff. Probably going to use that end phase, Oh, okay. So you might be able to do
anyway,
some
anyway, you were in the comments, and this guy...
Very funny. Very funny, haha. I think you're about to get tivered.
Probably, but he's only going to send one thing back.
Yeah, but then you're going to...
Will you just tell your drive-thru story? I'm
discard
anxious.
Discard from your hand and... Okay. So now with all this build-up, it's not going to be as fun. No, it's, So a guy comes through, and he's like... Yeah, I'll just take a double cheeseburger. I'm like, all right, sir. And what would you like on your double cheeseburger? He's, Sprite. I'm like, okay. And I just put him down for plain. I was like, is there anything else I can get for you? No, that'll be all.
Hey, we can put an asterisk on this duel now. He's using a banned card.
It's not banned yet.
It is. Oh, no, it's not. It's that list starts tomorrow.
Yep.
Spoiler alert, we just dated the video when we're recording this.
It's fine, he didn't do it for some reason. Now you can smashing ground, and it doesn't matter if he summons something on top of it, because it'll still work. Because
but maybe
that's
he'll
how
try
chains
it.
Work.
So anyway, okay, he was smarter.
You're not even going to try. So anyways, what would you like with your burger? Sprite. Okay. Is there anything else I can get for you? No, that'll be it. Okay, your total will be 431 at the next window. ketchup and mustard. And I just, like, I could not stop laughing. Like, oh, so you did hear me. You just got, like, minute-long lag. Is that it?
I would have made him the burger and put Sprite on it like he asked.
I went over and told the people the story. That was exactly like, so you want Sprite on? I'm like, holding up my finger. I'm like, one moment. And I tell him his total. No, ketchup and mustard. Like, oh, okay. He wants ketchup and mustard, guys. Oh, he's going to make a tiver.
Oh, now it's Trevor.
Tiver.
See how, see the R right there? It's Trevor.
Oh, there is an R there. I've been foolish this whole time.
I thought you were just deliberately mispronouncing it.
Yeah, I've been doing that. Was a joke. This like Necromanticer, where I'm supposed to be calling him Necromanticer, but it was just,
thing. That's shiny.
It negates dark effects, so don't use it.
It's all right. Can't I just fissure it?
Yep. Pretty sure you can fissure it. Yay. Now play the one that actually lets you grab a yellow gadget.
Yes, Joe.
You got a deck thin, otherwise you'll never get out of this. That's the thing about these gadgets, they're just a wee bit too slow, I think.
They were better when that format had them semi-limited, because we also had Ultimate Offering. So you could go gadget, pay 500, get another gadget, you'd end up searching a bunch, getting your hand replenished.
There's good times all around.
And swarming, and then at the time we didn't have Ixies. You could synchro if you had tuners.
You'd always synchro if you had tuners.
Oh.
Do you want a dark bribe that?
I don't think so.
He's blowing up his own card, though.
Yeah, but it'll give him another card.
It will? Oh, yeah. Good point. I'm just wondering what it... Because with Twin Twister, it's up to two cards.
Yeah.
So I wonder why he's destroying his own.
No.
What was it?
Storming Mirror Force.
Okay. Why would he do that?
I don't know, maybe he thought he had to do two?
Maybe. Maybe he didn't know you can right-click to cancel. My hiccups came back! God damn it! I was drinking all the soda to get rid of the hiccups and it worked, but now I drank too much again. I've come full circle.
Urkel?
Come full Urkel.
Hi-ho, Winslows!
Comment in the comments
if you know
who Urkel is.
I can't get my register up that high. It's just all about three material Ixies, isn't it?
Yeah.
Please, go into another Ptolemaeus the one day you can do it now.
One day of peace.
I don't run one day of peace.
One day until peace.
Although I remember when we could run three 1 days of peace, Joe. That was a great format.
That was a great format for Exodia, I tell you what.
Yes, it was.
Just three turns of being able to draw and not having to worry about... Oh, pardon me.
Sorry, Norwegian commenter who doesn't like bodily gases.
No, it's okay. That was a big guitar solo.
Okay! We're just gonna do another non-targeting spell onto his Ixies again.
This is
again.
Just every turn has been, I will make a big grand Ixie. You're like, Fissure? Hammer shot?
And he didn't use the effect. Alright. Alright, he surrendered. He got tired of us doing that.
Well then. Fifth duel?
Here we go.
Officially come untied. No, that was the fifth duel.
Oh. We leave you in the dust, fifth duel. Here we come, sixth duel. Okay, here we are, literally 25 minutes later. Joe had to take a hiccup break. We're playing against Dr. Nick.
Hi, everybody. I'm afraid to strain my voice because I think they'll come back. Like, I could feel it, like, deep down, like the hiccups in the back of my throat.
He only has a 3-card extra deck. So, probably not playing Exodia.
Probably not. Probably not Pepe. Probably not Monarchs either, unless they're weird Monarchs.
Let's go ahead and throw out our...
And you literally have, like, almost all your one-of cards.
Yep. No, I don't want to do that.
Can you just straight up, like, kill him right here?
No.
With litter removal?
Oh, if I wanted to go balls deep, I could.
32 plus 5,000. Quickest water deck ever.
Do we want to try it? What if these are things?
Do you want to build a snowman? Well, you have Raigeki and Call the Haunted.
Whatever.
It's up to you if you want to play it conservatively. I've played it conservatively myself.
Which one should I pitch?
I would pitch the other Machina Fortress.
The other fortress?
Because you can get it out of the graveyard.
That's true.
If need be.
Should I wait until damage calc to play that?
Oh, yeah. Definitely.
Okay.
Attack. Yeah, because that's the thing. You can wait until you attack. Attack with your big guy. Because if he has anything to negate it, he will with him.
Not yet. See?
Oh, see? There you go.
Now I chain it, right? So,
Now I chain it. It's got destroyed. He's your battle fade. He's going to fade your battles. Oh, into the main phase two. And you probably want to Raigeki that battle fader. So
probably not. But I will go ahead and equip it to that just in case.
And, sounds good.
I think we're good.
You don't want to call the Haunted just in case?
No, not yet.
Because what if he, castells your,
He's not castelling, he's stalling.
Stalltastic voyage!
Alright, now we'll do this.
Get deck thinning, the movie, the game, the animated experience. Part 2, The Legend of Curly's Gold.
Should I unequip it? And use it for more damage, or keep it on for protection?
Yeah, go and unequip.
I'm not going to like you if he does something.
Me either.
let's see here.
Use the 12 to attack the 0, Dan, because that has the least attack.
Notice I figured that out all on my own. See, I should have left it equipped.
Probably.
That's what I was afraid of, Joe. See, I told you I should leave it equipped.
I didn't think anyone actually played Mirror Force anymore.
Well, ain't that a tricky pickle.
You can, Raigeki.
I'd rather wait until he does something worth Raigeki.
This is why I don't play Raigeki, because I don't know how to use it. But yeah, maybe setting your traps would be good.
Do I just do, like, stupid advice when I'm your color commentator?
Yeah, that's why I don't have you here most of the time.
Oh, okay. Oh! I should Fiendish Chain that.
Maybe. It'd be mean.
Should I?
Is that both decks or just yours?
It's both. No, it's just mine.
Your call, bro.
Your recommendation, bro?
I would Fiendish Chain it.
Okay.
I don't even want to give him one shot, one opportunity. So says I, the captain.
I'm the captain.
Yeah, even though your face negates it.
But every captain relies on the input of his entire crew.
I thought I was like the admiral in charge of you.
No, just because your name's in the channel.
And on the P.O. box.
Oh yeah, P.O. box. Subscribe to the P.O. box.
That's not how P.O. box works. P.O. boxes work.
Sure it is.
Oh hey, you got your mega frame so you can get out your
I can.
Guy again.
Mm-hmm.
If you so wanted to.
I do kind of want to.
And then if he mirror forces again, you'll just get your mega frame back. Ho ho! Eat shit from a sandwich, you hoser.
He's probably got torrential tribute or something.
Maybe.
Oh no, okay.
But then you'll get your mecha form.
That's true.
Maximum over damage! Dun, 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 dun. Of course, if he deprisons, then you're gonna have a sad time.
Sad panda.
Yep. We'll be back.
Okay, we're back.
Damage calculation went through. All is well in the state of Denmark.
Now,
whatever traps he has, they're not traps that he wants to trap.
Now let's go ahead and banish his thing. Excellent.
You didn't try to banish that, you just happened to.
I should Raigeki now, right?
Yes.
Okay.
You can't. It's literally impossible.
I can do what I want, Joe. I'm the captain.
No, he has to have monsters on the field for you to destroy.
He's got a monster right there.
That's not on the field.
Sure it is.
That's a banished.
This is on the field.
That's to the graveyard.
I don't recall those being rules.
The graveyard's
annotations
not on the
field. To the first episode of nope. Dark Hole Elementary. Oh, look, it's Dark
Speaking
Hole.
Speaking of Dark Hole, that's fine.
I should call the Haunted on top of that, right? So
no.
Okay.
You should learn things.
I'll stop playing dumb, Joe.
It's okay, you get your mega form.
Side note, I don't actually play dumb.
I think people know that. It's okay. Well, your comment in the comments, who do you think is smarter, Hardleg Joe or Captain Cardsworth?
It what subject, though?
General life.
General life? Okay.
Or no, let's just say,
Does he outrank both of us, then?
Let's just say cards.
What kind of cards?
He's playing one of those.
Okay.
Yu-Gi-Oh cards.
Is he got, like, Necroface in there?
Probably.
Ooh, you know what? I wonder if he's got Inferno Tempest.
He might. Hit him for 3,000 at the same time.
Okay. So see, it's probably good that we didn't limit a removal.
Probably. I'd go ahead and normal summon your red gadget. It's only if he takes it from one battle.
Right. I know how Inferno Tempest works. I have that deck.
You do?
Yeah, you won't let me play it on here because it's too dumb.
Yeah. Yeah, it kind of is.
You're like, it's one single play. That's all your deck
it
does.
It is play. It's Grinder Golem attack. Or do you use Grinder Golem?
Yeah.
Yeah, Grinder Golem attack into it with the tokens. Inferno Tempest. Can they do anything?
Ooh, Storming Mirror Force. Hell, ain't got no counter to that.
Nope. Should have played your Dark Bribe.
I couldn't have used it this turn, Joe.
It's fine, because you don't play, like, Ixies and stuff like that.
I've got Ixies, I just haven't had a chance to get to them yet.
Now that Megaform's back in your hand, you could summon out your Machina Fortress again.
I could. I'll wait.
Okay.
We'll see what we do, because I got Call of the Haunted. And I don't think he's going to OTK. I think he's waiting for us to, do things. Oh, now I can't use Megaform.
Should have used it while you had the chance. It's okay, you can blow it up next turn.
That's true.
Wait, will it go to... No, well... Oh yeah, because that only... D-Prison or D-Fissure only does monsters, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Which one, left or right, Joe?
Left.
Left?
Yep.
Alright.
No, all left.
All left?
Yeah.
Alright, oh...
Ooh, Book of Eclipse. I would just wait because you don't want to banish that mega form.
Yeah.
I would just normal summon one of your gadgets.
Okay, he surrenders.
He surrendered because he knew that his thing was going to go.
We'll be back next...
seventh duel.
Next duel. Kind of curious what he has.
I'm not.
Yeah, me neither. Oh, we're here against a Gibbsy-ing-ing.
Gibbsy, it's probably Yang Zings.
No, it's Gibbs Yang Ying.
Yang
could
Ying's.
Be anything. Could even be a boat.
Could even be a boat.
We have no spell support.
It could even cook an egg. It could even cook an egg.
Can you put that on a button?
Maybe. I don't think anyone knows what that's from except for me.
Can you put that clip on the screen, Joe?
Hardly anyone... No, that last time you had me put a clip on, it took me forever because I had to find it.
I told you exactly where it was!
I know, but it's hard to put video in video.
Yeah, I know.
On a huge, long video like this.
Yeah, I know. I use the same editor as you.
I know. I told you about it. Welcome back to the Hardsworth and Cardleg show, where we just talk to each other and ignore the fact that there's an audience there.
Hi, audience!
It's like the
How
biggest...
are you?
You... What was it? You've never been to the Let's Play subreddit, have you?
There's a Reddit?
Yeah.
What's Reddit?
It's like a forum.
I know. I have Reddit. I've been to the Let's Play Reddit.
You can't see, but I'm shaking my head.
You're always shaking your head, though.
Yeah.
Let's just poke for 12 and probably take damage.
Probably.
What's he got?
2,000. Scram. Burning Abyss again.
Dragon Dwelling in the Cave.
Mystical Elf.
Island Turtle.
Giant Soldier of Stone. It is Yang Zings!
No, it's Gradle Zings.
Gradle Zings?
Zingle.
Oh, no.
I got a better one. Zingles.
Zingles?
Zingles.
So he's going to take your
yellow gadget. Oh. Well, ain't that a dick in the head? Well, how quickly the field has turned against me.
It's okay. When he tries to synchro, you've got the solemn warning. Unless he plays...
Which I prefer over Solemn Strike. Comment in the comments which is better.
Solemn Strike is better.
I'd argue Warning is better.
No.
Yes.
Clearly, it costs less and it negates more things.
No, but it negates different things.
Slightly. But
Warning is better.
Warning is better if you need to stop summons by any means necessary.
Oh, look at this.
But you could Solemn Strike that. Yeah. And it costs you 500 less.
Yes, but this gives me more opportunity than Solemn Strike.
I guess, like, if they use...
I don't know if I already asked it, but comment in the comments which is better, Solemn Warning or Solemn Strike.
You want to use your lizard while you've got no level 5 or higher?
The point of him is to be able to get gear frame out of the grave, and then I can either synchro with him, which I don't have any synchros in here now that I think about it.
Oh, he can only get gear frame?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Zero defense.
I thought it was just any level 4 monster.
No.
Well, then I guess just go ahead and throw out your green gadget. Have a fun old time. A dang old fun old time. I'm going to sneeze, and I hope it does not trigger more hiccups. Please, Lord, if you exist. Okay, thinking about God maybe or maybe not existing, it causes...
Oh, he's going to waste a dark hole on that. Okay.
It seems like a dumb thing to waste a dark hole on.
Indeed.
You're going to have not enough stuff.
I'll just have to set something.
Yeah.
That's fine.
Yeah, you will.
Really? Okay.
Negated, so says the captain. Well, he just saved me the trouble of having to set something.
Wow, okay.
More damage for me. Like, no, I can't let him have that yellow gadget. It'll be instrumental to his plans.
All right, well, now we can Ixie something.
We can.
Oh, but I can't get my thing with it now. Oh, well.
Why not?
I can't, because it'll negate the effect.
Oh, yeah.
See this right here,
yeah,
Joe?
Yeah.
Right
yeah.
Here where you're circling, the effects of all monsters on the field are negated.
Oh, I was just circling. I was just zooming in on your face there on the cards.
Not even going to need to activate it. Now, what do I have in here?
Do you have Crazy Box? Because Crazy Box is awesome.
Actually, no, I don't have Crazy Box.
Actually, he'll probably steal it from the grave, so you want to take something that's not that great.
So, nothing?
I'd say Black Ship, maybe.
Black Ship?
Wait. Don't Ixie summon.
Don't?
Yeah, because he's most likely got Gradles and Yang Zings.
Good point. He hasn't played any monsters in a while. I forgot what he had.
Yeah. I mean, if he takes one of those, what's he going to do? Suicide into you? Oh, or give it 200 more defense?
Okay.
Or no, more attack.
Oh, and that's the one that's if it's a spell effect, so my things are going to help it now.
Yeah, you want to wait until he gets something else out.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, with Gradles, the trick is to not summon huge fuck-off monsters.
It's to swarm with little things.
Yeah, and always keep your thing...
Oh, there's his supply squad.
Yep.
Sure he's been waiting on that. Okay, problem solved. He got rid of it for me.
But he's going to summon something else.
I know. Oh, I'm trying to be optimistic.
Well, don't.
They were with me in the audience.
No, you weren't.
Isn't that right, audience?
Don't answer that. No.
I'm the captain. They will answer me.
You don't answer anything except for the things we asked you to answer before. This may be really bad for you.
Yeah, probably. Is it going to make big fuck off Gradle Dragon?
If it does, it won't get its effect. I think it... I don't know. How does that work with the Yang Zings?
It's like, only on the field, so... And their effect are going to activate in the grave, so they'll get all their
effects.
Their
don't activate their, like, conditions or some
weird
shit.
But it's like Sangin, you know, when they're sent to the grave.
No, I mean, like, if he synchros something out using the Yang Zings, will it have effects?
Oh. Mm-hmm. I can't be expected to play Yu-Gi-Oh! While I'm playing Yu-Gi-Oh!
Okay. Which two ones did he summon out, by the way?
This thing. Jurutu, Darkness of Yang Zing. And,
the other two.
The other two that aren't there anymore.
Think about it.
All right.
You can't beat 2,000. You're going to have to Ixie summon something.
Yeah.
Or wait, no, you could Fissure it.
I could Fissure it.
But then it'll just get, he'll get the Yang Zing thing, it'll let him draw.
Mm-hmm.
And the,
But he'll summon it in attack mode.
True. You just want to keep dealing damage. And then just summon some big fuck-off thing. A big fuck-off Ixie.
Let's see what we can do.
Because, I mean, if he takes it, you've got a Fissure.
So he did some things.
Yeah.
I guess we should Ixie.
Yep. Something that can do some damage.
I guess I should probably just do Gear-Gigant.
Yeah. Seems like a good idea.
Since, yeah, that won't work.
Save
yeah.
your strongest so you can counter it if need be.
Yeah, we'll just have to do that. All right.
Just give him the 2300 tickle.
Any preference on which one? Oh, okay!
Well, then.
Never mind!
You're just winning all these surrenders.
Hey, you know, a win's a win, right?
Point is, you did better than James.
Well, that's because James is terrible at everything, including Pokemon. Hidden power changes based on the... Every time. We'll be back. All right, well, here we are.
I'm happy.
Here we are in the eighth duel against...
Smiley Face?
Yes.
Anime Smiley Face. Konnichiwa!
Oh, he has a 6-card extra
Ohio.
Deck.
And you're going first.
We are going first.
I think you should do that move where you play Gear Frame.
You think so?
Yes.
Okay. I can do that.
And just add stuff? But then I don't think he's going to OTK, so maybe don't necessarily throw everything out there yet.
Yeah.
Because next turn you could start doing that thing where you're like, I play a gadget, I grab a gadget, and then
You were like, I don't want to sit in the captain's chair because I don't know how this deck works, and here you are telling me how to do my own deck.
You're welcome.
Should I set this, Joe?
Yes.
What do you think, Captain?
Yes.
Okay.
Captain Saltsworth. We still need to get that fan art. Someone needs to do
it. Kale?
We need a fan art of, like, Captain Cardsworth standing outside a...
Ooh.
I wouldn't.
Yeah, I wouldn't. He can do what he wants.
Yeah.
Okay.
During the end phase, he'll tribute it unless he gets some sort of... He's playing Burning Abyss.
Is he?
Yeah. And I guess he just has nothing but Dantes. So he gets to add one spell.
Three Dantes and then what? Three,
I don't know.
Virgils, maybe?
Maybe. It's Forbidden Lance.
Oh, there's the Rhino you were talking about.
Yeah, other fiends cannot be destroyed by battle or card effects if this card is sent to the graveyard. Ooh!
Ooh.
Darkness Necrosphere. Interesting choice.
By sending one fiend you control and from your hand to the graveyard when your opponent declares an attack. Cannot be destroyed by battle. Can return all face-up traps you control to the hand.
But he has to control one on the field.
Yeah.
So I would just swarm...
With
like,
everything.
Normal summon... Or yeah. Yeah, if you normal summon one of your gadgets, and then you could do two Machina Fortresses.
Yeah. No, I don't want to warning my own thing.
But you have that option, if you want
to. I do. Unofficially.
Unofficially.
Because you don't believe how the game works.
Oh, no, I believe how it works. I just wish they said... I'll get to that later. Point is, I was discussing the fan art of you, where you open up your own salt mine.
Yeah.
And it's just like, someone needs to draw this picture, like Captain Cardsworth standing there with his arms crossed in like a frowny face outside of like a big sign that says like Captain Cardsworth salt mine.
82? Is that 82?
I don't know.
5,000? Yeah, I think that's enough.
Either way, you can make Cowboy.
Yeah, that's true. I can
main
add.
Phase 2. Unless he's got Tragoedia.
He's got something. He's got the gores.
Solomit.
No, I'm sorry, because Counter Trap can activate in damage step.
Fuck your shit! You get no gores from me. Just in case he's got another one, even though it's limited?
It's not limited, it's semi-limited, isn't it?
I thought it's only at one. Is semi.
I thought gores was at two.
Hmm.
And look, punch for game. Well, there we go, we won by not surrender.
Yay!
Sorry,
take that,
Smiley.
Smiley Face. You go back to the pig fuck farm where you came from.
We'll be back. And we're playing against TSC-225. Wasn't that the Stormtrooper in Force Awakens?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's a Stormtrooper.
With the spinny doodad that everybody loves, like the new Boba Fett?
I don't know. I thought the new Boba Fett was the one
chick. It was supposed to be
the...
Captain Phasma, but,
Yeah. You
know, everybody suddenly threw her in the trash compactor when that Stormtrooper with the spinny doodad, you know,
with
took
the thing
the world
that fights
by storm.
Lightsabers,
yeah.
For whatever reason.
It's probably made out of Cortosis.
What's Cortosis?
It's a thing from,
Go ahead.
It's a thing from something.
From the expanded
I think
universe?
It's Knight of the Old Republic had it. It was like, lightsaber resistant. No, it was Jedi Outcast. That's what it was. It's lightsaber resistant material. Yeah, it's Jedi Knight Outcast 2 or whatever that game was. Oh, Twin Twister. Well, there goes my torrential tribute.
Oh,
is he playing UAs?
Hell yeah! Go UAs! Go UAs!
Isn't this the deck of yours that I can never beat with this deck in real
yeah.
life?
It's the one that you hate. Use the jersey, summon out for batter. But he doesn't have the... Okay, he has the field spell, but he's not UO. Well, then.
I think we're in trouble, Joe. You might want to pencil this in as a loss.
Hard to say. Ooh, he's gonna tag out in the battle phase. Like a bitch.
What? What? He can do that in the battle phase?
Yep.
Should I scarecrow it?
Yeah, because I think he can, like, make its attack go up 800. Haha. Pitcher.
Let's pretend during your opponent's turn. So he can negate.
And he can negate a special summon. Yep. Well, if you... Okay. If you fissure, he'll... What would that kill?
It would kill that, but he'll negate it.
Yeah, but then he can't negate your,
Why can't he... Does this negate?
That negates the effects of a special summon monster and changes its battle position. But what you can do, it's... What was it? It's... Yeah, because Machina Gearframe doesn't have effects anyway. So Fissure, he'll negate it, and then he won't be able to negate your summon of Gearframe. You can use Gearframe to get another, mega form. Or something. I don't know where you go from there. Cause you
shouldn't I summon Chameleon to get my other Gearframe out of the grave?
Probably.
And then he'll negate it. But it'll be... won't matter anyway.
Yeah.
Oh, he just let that go through.
He didn't want to
discard a card.
Yeah.
Alright, well...
Do it!
Oh, I could do this with Scarecrow.
You could, if you were dumb.
Oh no, it's negated.
I'm not sure if that was his effect. I think he gets to choose. It's once per turn.
Once per turn, when your opponent special summons, you can... change their battle positions, and if you do, negate their effects. Okay.
So I think you think if you tried to summon Fortress and hope that he tries to negate its effects, even though it can't be doing anything, alternatively, make Castell and just send it back to his hand. He'll negate its effect.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think your best bet is to try to bait him into using it by summoning Fortress, because otherwise you've lost anyway.
Oh, I can't special summon it. Except from the extra deck.
During the turn you activate this effect. Well, do you have any...
Well, what if I bait him in with Crab King? Because if I summon that out, if he tries to negate the effect, he'll change his battle position into defense mode, and I'll have a 3,000 defense wall.
True. Go for it.
And if not, then we're golden anyway.
Yep. What say you, football man?
Alright, so he either lets it go and then we end up with a 3,000 attacker, or he negates it and we have a 3,000 wall. I'm happy with that for now.
Yep, I'm not sure if he can...
Alright, well...
He still has that one guy who can get a whole lot of attack.
Yeah, but this was our best play, I think.
Yeah, at least we got rid of
with
one of
his
aces.
With our available resources.
Just a matter of can he get another ace...
Yeah.
Probably.
It's UAs, most definitely. Oh!
Oh! 3,100.
He got over 3,000, Joe.
That's too much.
My pretty blue crab is gonna go away, Joe.
It's not blue, it's white.
It's blue, right here. See in the big circle you're putting on the screen again?
Why do you keep making me... This thing takes, 3 hours to edit as is. Just putting in, the wins, losses, and the cuts through everything. And you're like, no, I want you to do more edits.
I ask for simple edits. I'm not asking you to put a picture of shirtless Drew on the screen.
I don't have a picture of shirtless Drew.
Well, that can be rectified.
I don't think Drew wants to show his shirtless body to millions of people.
Millions? We have 1,300s.
I know, but if we put his shirtless body up on the screen, we'd have millions.
That's true.
Girls would be flocking from all over.
Well, why didn't you lower your attack first?
Why would you lower his attack?
You've never tagged out in the battle phase with me, have you?
No.
Why not? Because you're dumb?
No, because I think that's stupid. I don't like doing that.
Yeah. Oh, hey, there's our friend.
Yep.
And there's our other friend. What does he do? Isn't he the one that doesn't hurt us?
He can stop one of his monsters from being destroyed by battle or card effects. I think you've lost.
I think we have two. Yep.
GG.
Well, okay!
Fucking timeout.
We were going to call that a loss, but I guess Tixie there couldn't decide whether he wanted to negate Fortress or not.
This is why you don't surrender. And it's an asterisk.
It'll be an asterisk, but we will
win.
We'll be back in the 10th and final duel after this. Okay, here we are in the 10th and final duel against Polo Games.
Or Pollo Games, if they're Spanish.
Anybody?
Which means chicken games. Oh no.
No.
Oh no. And they're going second. They want maximum card advantage. You better get your machine out. You better equip it with some things.
I could technically get it out.
I'd just wait. I don't think... If you're going to get OTK'd, you're going to get OTK'd. You just got to let it happen.
Yeah.
It's just got to be one with your inner happening.
That's a terrible movie. We never talk of it.
No.
Uh-oh. Uh-oh.
They got a cyber dragon.
Oh,
uh-oh.
No. We might get Cyber Infinity the right way, Joe.
I know. The one that actually cost at least 3 cards to make. Without, giving you any sort of advantage. Well, I guess it does kind of get advantage. But still, they had to draw those 2 cards. They had to make a deck specifically to make Cyber Dragon Infinity.
Okay, no, he's just going to go... Oh, yeah, he is.
Yeah.
I'm used to requiring 3 to go into Ptolemaeus first.
Nope. 2 level 5 machine-type monsters.
That's okay. If I can draw my Cyber Dragon, I'll just Chimera Tech into it. Otherwise, I can just burn both of these to kill it.
Yay.
Oh, but he's going to hit me for 29. I always forget that it actually absorbs things, too.
Yeah. Doesn't even have to detach to do that.
Yeah.
That's...
Ooh.
He'll negate it.
Yeah, good point. Might as
well save
it.
Don't even waste it. Don't even waste it. You just gotta hope he doesn't also have, Forbidden Lance or some foolishness like that.
True. Nope. Well, okay, he's not gonna play him. Alright, we didn't get our Cyber Dragon. I was really hoping to do that, but that's fine. We'll do it this way.
He's like, ha ha, smashing ground, I negate. Who do you think you are? You think you could topple my thing with that? And it's like, Fissure?
Oh no, whatever will I do? Alright, I have this too.
Yep. Right to the nipples. That claw just reaching
out. Well, I have nothing to play.
Yeah, you do.
Should I go for Fortress?
Yeah.
And pitch what, Scarecrow or?
Megaform. Because then if he kills Megaform, or if he kills your Machina Fortress, you can get Megaform back.
Why can't I?
You gotta unclick. Yeah, you just discard.
Oh, yeah.
He's 8 stars.
I know how this works in real life. It's playing on here that is different.
Let's just hope he can't summon a another Cyber Dragon Infinity next turn. Let's hope it's not that much turbo. Well, either way, if he targets you, you could discard from his hand. If he negates that, then he won't be able to negate your
magic. He's adding one to his hand, so he's going to summon a Cyber Dragon. More than likely, unless he goes... Yep, he's going to bring out a Cyber Dragon, Joe.
And he still has that other one from, what, he added it last turn?
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah. Cyber Dragon Infinity Turbo, ladies and gentlemen.
I may have to build this deck, because I love my Cyber Dragon Infinity.
Yep.
Except I hate Galaxy Soldier. It's a terrible looking card.
It is weird. It's like a weird Power Ranger-y kind of guy, but lame.
Go, go, Power Rangers!
And you gotta run that Solar Wind Jammer, because that's another level 5 machine.
Mighty Morphin Voltron Ranger Crane. Oh, look, it's our old friend, the Cyber Infinity Dragon.
I remember him. He was a cool guy when we did the thing.
Okay, what should we get rid of?
His
limiter removal? Actually, no, because he might use that. Well, no, I have to chain that on attack declaration.
Yeah. I would just get rid of his Galaxy Soldier so he can't do it again.
Okay.
He didn't negate it. So you could do...
It'll resolve backwards, though. It's not going to matter.
No, if you do both, you can only negate one. So wait, activate Swift Scarecrow, and then activate, if he negates it, then you can activate Magic Cylinder.
Okay.
Ah, you bitch! Oh, but, oh yeah.
That's why I tried backwards. To tell you it goes backwards.
I gotcha.
Well, we better hope we draw our Cyber Dragon here.
That would be cool.
I have two of them in there.
Oh, no, he gets blown up.
Oh, it goes away anyway.
Yeah, because...
Well,
you got your limiter removal. That's good. We're both down to a card.
Should I set it?
No.
Okay.
Why would you put it on the field where it could be hurt? In your hand, it's safe. It's secret. And he can't Cyber Dragon if you don't have anything.
He can do that Cyber Dragon.
He has the other Cyber Dragon.
Okay, well, he's just going to 18.
That's fine. You know, we'll be back when more interesting things happen.
Oh, no. Oh, no. You've done it again, Joe. Oh, no, okay. Should I eat this 25?
No, I would just do it. Because if he gets Cyber Infinity Dragon out...
Good point.
Plus, now if you get nearly anything and he can't make another one, you could just make his Quick Draw Synchron, like, eat a dick.
That's true.
What?
What did he do? Oh, he Chimera Tech'd.
Why?
So I couldn't eat his dick.
Oh, okay.
Well.
You just gotta hope he doesn't get something. And hope that you get another monster next turn. Because any monster from your deck, except for that reptile, if you get that reptile, is gonna be foolish.
Okay, we might be in this still.
This is a tense duel.
It is.
I'm gonna lie.
I'm on the edge of Drew's lap right now.
I'm like about to pee my pants. I hope you win, because otherwise this is gonna be a very messy basement. Kind? That stalls for another turn.
Yeah.
Set limiter removal first. And then set that. Okay. For some reason I was like, end phase MST.
Yeah, it's a risk. Should I book a moon this, right, Joe?
Yeah, I mean, it has zero defense, so...
Oh my!
These people just give up too easily.
He would have probably won that if he hadn't done that.
I wish I could know what your next card was.
I wish I could, too.
Was saving the replay do that, or is it just a little randomized?
Actually, yeah, it will. I think it does.
Okay, we'll tell you on the end screen. And there you go, that's the Machina Gadget deck. It went 8-2. A lot of that was from Salty Surrenders. Looking at that last deck, if that guy had stuck around, he probably would have won. Which just goes to show you shouldn't surrender. Same thing with our UA battle. We probably, because we didn't surrender, he timed out, win. A win is a win is a win. Oh, that was a
strong
burp.
You just couldn't get out of the outro without doing that.
I could not. So there you go, there's Captain Cardsworth. Any last words for that, Captain?
Banana bread.
Excellent. So next week I'll be back with something of my own creation. Hopefully something of the Kleehorp variety, if I can get it to work properly. Until then, good luck, and have fun.
Pumpkin bread.
I hate you.